Good morning, my friends, my brothers, and my sisters in Jesus Christ. This is the morning mindset edition of the Live, Build, Change podcast. And I am excited about talking about the topic we have today because it's one of the most powerful, most significant mindset shifts that we can make at any point in our lives because it has to do with our identity. It's that powerful. It has to do with how we view ourselves. And I'm here to tell you that the way you view yourself will dictate the way you live in the world. The things you do, the things you don't do, the boldness you have or the lack thereof. All kinds of ways that your self-identity, the way you identify yourself, will impact the way that you live. And in Romans chapter 6, which is the passage we've been looking at over the last few days, Paul has just taught us in verse number 11, that it is our responsibility, based on the truth of what Jesus has done for us at the cross and by rising from the grave, and by taking us with him to the cross and up from the grave, it is our responsibility to consider ourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. So because of Jesus, we can consider those things to be true. And I mentioned yesterday that we have got to learn how to do that, not in a fanciful way where we're hoping it's true, but in a way where we're fully accepting it as what God says is true. And think about that statement for just a moment. It's the God of the universe who says this is true. Who are we to reject it? Who are we to say, well, I don't always feel like it's true, so maybe it's not true? God has said it is true. And so our job is not to figure out why what we feel is more powerful than what God says. Our job is to figure out how what God says applies to what we feel. Do you see the difference? And Paul today says that the mindset shift is the key. He says you must consider yourself dead to sin and alive to God. You must accept that it's true. You must believe that it's true, all the way down to the core of your being. And he says then in verse 12, as a response to that truth, let not sin, therefore, reign in your mortal body to make you obey its passions. He's saying because you have a new identity, because you have an identity as one who has new life and is no longer a slave to sin, you have just entered into a warfare. It is a warfare against sin. And he says, so your responsibility as that new creation, the one who considers himself dead to sin, is to not let sin reign in your mortal body to make you obey its passions. He's saying you can't allow it. You can't be a passive bystander anymore when temptation comes. And the reason this is so critically tied to the issue of identity is because much of the reason we fail when it comes to temptation and sin is because we have told ourselves, and maybe well-meaning pastors have told us, we are sinners saved by grace. Now, I know what they mean, and there is truth to it. We were at one time sinners, but we keep saying it in the present tense when Paul and Jesus do not say it in the present tense anymore. They say we died to sin. We are now dead to sin and alive to God. We are no longer sinners. And so we've got to embrace that mentally and begin telling ourselves, I'm not a sinner saved by grace. I'm not one who is prone to sin, is going to sin, is doomed to sin. In fact, God says, I can no longer allow sin to reign in my mortal body. I can't put up with that anymore. I have to fight it because it's not who I am anymore. That's the real point. I want you to ponder that today as temptation arises, as you're tempted to spout off at somebody in anger or be short with your children or whatever. Remind yourself, I am dead to this. It is not in my nature or my identity to do this any longer. I'll talk to you on the Morning Mindset Edition tomorrow.